Polycythemia refers to an elevation in red cells, as indicated by elevated hemoglobin and hematocrit levels. Hemoglobin levels greater than 185 grams per liter in males and 165 grams per liter in females are typically found in patients with polycythemia. Polycythemia may be a relative polycythemia, resulting from dehydration or volume contraction, or an absolute polycythemia, where there is a true increase in the number of red cells. Absolute polycythemia may be primary or secondary. Primary polycythemia or polycythemia vera is caused by a mutation in a protein that stimulates red blood cell production, i.e. the JAK2 V617F mutation. Patients can be tested for this mutation, which is positive in 80 to 95% of patients with polycythemia vera. Secondary polycythemia is due to conditions such as sleep apnea or hypoxia that stimulate EPO to produce red cells. Inappropriate erythropoietin production is seen in patients with rare tumors. Medications such as synthetic EPO and testosterone can also stimulate red cell production. Patients with polycythemia vera can be asymptomatic. However, they often suffer hyperviscosity symptoms, vertigo, burning of the extremities, headaches, or thrombotic symptoms such as deep vein thrombosis, pulmonary embolus, hepatic vein thrombosis, myocardial infarction, stroke or digital infarcts, and critical limb ischemia. Patients may also have symptoms of gout, heartburn, or pruritus due to excessive histamine release from mast cells. Patients can also have bleeding symptoms. Once a diagnosis of polycythemia is made, a referral to a hematologist for further management is appropriate. Medications that may be contributing to polycythemia must be stopped. Smoking cessation can often normalize hemoglobin levels, and this must be strongly encouraged in patients with all forms of polycythemia. In patients with polycythemia vera, therapeutic phlebotomy is indicated to reduce the hematocrit to 45%. Aspirin, 81 mg a day, is started, and a cytoreductive agent, such as hydroxyurea, may be initiated by a hematologist. The primary care provider has a role in managing cardiac risk factors, such as hypertension, hyperlipidemia, and glycemic control, as the most common cause of death in patients with polycythemia is due to thrombotic complications.